Right, hello everybody, welcome to a cheeky 450 TV difference. PI, the Spanish, what is it? Podcast, isn't it? Spanish podcast. And he's 4-3-1. Let's see what he gets with his millions of inducements. Bolt bitch might be getting to make a touchdown. Yep. It's stupid, isn't it? Like, it is stupid that the you can't help it as well, can you? There's nothing you can do about it. It's just the way it is. We need more people playing, really. Beastman level 2, is that like a dirty player or something, just to try and tilt me? I'm not sure about the Beastman. It must be a dirty player. That seems weird. Like, you wouldn't get a guard guy, would you? Although the guard guy might be probably better than the dirty player. It's got to be the dirty player, hasn't it? That's surely what he's doing. Tu vas embrouiller les spectateurs, Jim. Ce qu'il veut dire, c'est qu'ils se vendent bien. Toi qui vous tire dessus quand vous les achetez. Scum's a babe. 50 TV down, man. Never lucky. Never lucky. Uphill here. Yeah, Borak and Wizard, I think, was better. But I guess he thinks he can high roll with a dirty player, which I guess he could. Like, it's maybe he's not that bad. But I think the Wizard is scarier, isn't it? I feel like the better play is to make the Dwarves care about the ball and... He's got a match 4 guy, so with a Wizard would have... Couldn't go ham if he's got a Wizard. Yeah, he's a dirty player. Whereas, now, basically have to go ham. Like, there's no other thing for it. Move, you bastard. Oh my fucking god. What a setup this is. Oh dear. Hello. Yeah, like you can get lucky, can't you? With it. Like, I genuinely don't hate the Wizard player because he can. The Wizard, the dirty player player, because he can just try high roll, can't he? Like, obviously against armor 9 thick skull. It's generally not good to foul them. But if you think it's that desperate, then it can be alright, can't it? Wow, yeah. I mean, again, it's just high roll, isn't it? Like, I don't know if it's a nice tactic. It's good if the dice are good. Bribes are always good if the dice are good. But not if they aren't. Or, like, good if the game goes well. Bribes are good if the game goes well. Whereas I like apples for if the game goes badly. But then I guess it depends how confident you are of, like, the matchup and you play and stuff. Like, if you think the only way you can win is to high roll somebody, then you're not going to high roll anybody with apples, are you? You know, you ain't going to high roll anyone with an apple, but you can high roll them with bribes and fouling every turn. So. Yeah, maybe, but yeah, foul with Borak. Yeah, Jahanian, yeah, it's not a bad shot. Yeah, exactly. You don't win anything with apples, yeah. Yeah. I mean, but you can, though, can't you? Because you can keep your players on the field, can't it? Like, you know, it can keep you with 11 men for the second half or whatever. Or keep an early KO, you can keep them on the field. Help you that drive, help you stop them score. So, the apples. I do like apples. I do like apples. Yeah, but I mean, but that's the thing. I'm usually quite confident, no matter how much TV I'm down, you know. And then if I'm down by so much TV that I'm not confident, then I'll probably just get an apple to save a good player because the shit's really got to have hit the fan, you know. So. Did he get a bribe as well? No, he got a babe. He got a babe in the DP. I nearly put the stand firmers on the corners. That would have maybe been better. Don't break AV, you motherfucker. You'd have been 2D'd, wouldn't he? You'd have been 2D'd if you didn't get the armor break. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I guess the roller could blitz to complete the 2D. Yeah, that's fair, Moradam. Yeah, that's fair. But he could have failed to break AV and got sent off. We've seen that in matches before. He's got edge 4 there, hasn't he? No, so this is a bit of a risky pickup. Two assist foul? Did he go for that? Yes, he gets the two. Oh, not into the crowd. Boo. Right. He's going to go there. Guard in here, which is him. Death roller. Didn't even kill him. What a stupid joke of a shit game. I can't even believe it. Zero removals. Armor 8 versus Mighty Blow. Why wasn't it an instant Kaz? Very cautiously. Yeah, indeed. It's the biggest brain players are dwarf teams. It's all about the biggest... Who's got the biggest brain when you've got dwarves? Yeah, I mean, I'd like to have obviously got rid of one of them, wouldn't I? I was thinking maybe I should have pushed into the roller and like stood firm. But I didn't want to. I don't know why. I just didn't want to. Maybe I should have done. It is shameful, isn't it? Yeah. Yeah, it is. I'm not proud of it. Hey. It's 1D for Grashnak, isn't it? 7, 8, 9 against 9. He's got to hit this guy. And then get fucking rolled. You prick. Again, he's in danger of going to the crowd, so has to re-roll. Okay, doesn't have to re-roll. What the fuck? Get out! What the fuck are you playing at? Jack, we go. He re-rolled it as well. What a madman! What an absolute madman! What the hell? Just willfully throwing away a re-roll on turn two after he's thrown one away on turn one, which he kind of had to. But wow, that's amazing. That's lovely. Beautiful. This was probably not the game to get that completion in, I would say. In my opinion. This is not the game to do it. Three, four, five, six. I could get 2D on him easily, actually. He just naturally does it, look. And then there's block. Much better than the roller doing it. Zero AV breaks allowed. Do have a lot on this side. Maybe I'll just dodge out the roller. Because it's like, it got so outnumbered him so much here. I think 3-dicing the dirty player was valid. But, like, against Elliot, I ended up I ended up, I was weak on one side and he nearly scored, didn't he? So I thought this time, let's shore up. Hey, no block. He's out of rerolls. He's out of rerolls on turn three. Beautiful. Yeah, that is tragic. The good thing is that with strength six, he's still good, isn't he? Maybe not good enough to keep, but he's still good. Yeah, Janie. Yeah, so technically correct. The worst kind of correct in this case. No, he told us yesterday, I'd already commiserated with him. Oh man. Fabled roller blitz. Nope, he's realized that rollers pretty good. So I'm 1D Grashnak at the end, which is alright, isn't it? Lets us do other things as well after it. He has to go there. And he has to go here. And he has to go there. And now I know I've got Juggernaut this time. Don't even need it. This lets us move him across, doesn't it? Which is alright. Or back. I could go in there, then it's a 2D and a 2D and a 1D. But this is kind of outside of where it matters, isn't it? I can't afford to lose over here. Be serious for a minute and rely on Dauntless. Maybe I shouldn't have done that because now you can dodge him away. I don't want to reroll these 1Ds, but this is a pretty good 1D now. Don't have to reroll this. That was a freebie. I guess he has to keep him occupied. Yeah, that slayer's very dauntable, yeah. Full of daunt. Yeah, dauntful. That's brilliant. Oh, imagine that Muppet, yeah, but I mean, no, that would be pretty stupid, wouldn't it? it would be pretty horrible for the people who needed them. There's a problem with dwarves, isn't it? You're so slow that I found it out against Elliot. Like, it's hard to, you can't get the pressure on the backfield guy. Like, really need some removals. You can't pressure the backfield guy without letting them away through. Like, obviously, I had loads of removals against Elliot. I need to power this warrior, don't I? That's what I need. He does not have Juggernaut, does he? So I can safely go there. Get him, and then he can get through. Ce joueur est à terre et entouré par les joueurs. Ça risque de ne pas être beau à voir. Gets his cheeky DP following. No, I mean it. I don't count it as any luck at all, to be fair. Doesn't really matter, does it? It might matter further down the line, but it doesn't matter immediately. Oh, that shores up the running way. The breaking through, rather. Slayer can still do stuff. He comes in here. Yeah. He goes there with his stand firm. He could blitz, I guess. No. Roller can blitz if he has to. That makes this frenzy hit a lot better, so I don't need the power on the initial hit. Oh, except it's still blocked my way through. Oh, didn't think of that, did I? Oh, fuck off. I guess not, that's alright, actually. Fuck off. Oh, no, it's okay. Yeah, I mean, it would have been better, obviously, if he could have gone in there, wouldn't it? Because then it's only a 1D for him and stuff. So it would have been better for him to have not gone wrong. Yeah, it wasn't a great foul, but he's thinking he's got to get lucky, hasn't he? That's the thing. Basing the ball's actually all right, isn't it, when he's got no rerolls at all? Oh, thanks, Jobu12. Hey, he's got no rerolls. So this was always the danger, wasn't it? Nearly assist with a roller. I think this is the better play, though.
Whoops.
Oh, fuck, he's there. Oh, fuck me, I'm an idiot. Am I an idiot? Maybe. He could 1D, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then he could blitz 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, GFI. I could just 1D blitz. I could 2D blitz him, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, double GFI. Fucking needed a power on that. Maybe I should have followed and then relied on the roller. Oh, he could blitz. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, that's not good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then he runs through. Got the reroll. Yeah, boy. Glorious. Yeah, the early cheat, I thought he was just going to concede if anything gone wrong once he did that. I genuinely thought he was just going to concede like the same turn or whatever, or like the second something bad happened, I expected to concede after that passing play. It was pretty crazy.
I play on Xbox. Oh no.
Whining a hell of a lot for a guy who's had nobody removed by by an absolutely ridiculously violent dwarf team. I want to uphill Grashnak three times
then,
to surf him now.
You've got to fucking suck it up. Stop bitching like a little baby and try and fucking play better, eh?
That could be the straw that breaks the camel's back. Three uphills to surf Grashnak. Oh man. L'union fait la force, comme on dit. I mean, that was the second worst scatter for him, but there was still a lot. Yeah, I mean, that's the thing. Like, obviously, I've made some 1Ds, but they've been low-risk 1Ds. Like, he shouldn't be tilted by or complaining about these 1Ds because, yeah, I've had a reroll for the... Like, if they mattered, I had a reroll for them. And if they didn't matter, well, they didn't matter, did they? Oh, boo, no more surf. Jim Shard.
Gloria.
Shard.
No, I won't give in until I'm victorious, and I will defend. I will defend.
Nah, I can't surf Grashnak anymore. Like, if he hadn't blocked, could have uphilled him, then uphilled him, and then uphilled him off. Should have been pretty good. Look a dog. Glorious, what was that? Sorry, I missed that there. I was getting so excited by what was going on. Elp meme, thank you very much for staying fantastic for 10 whole months. 2.5 beaver pregnancies, absolutely glorious. Thank you very much, Elp. Hey, you gotta love that he fucking fails, haven't you? Fucking class. Right. What's this? He could go there, then he could blitz. He could do a GFI. He could blitz him and then chain out him, who then runs there and surfs him. I like that play, but it's stupid because it's got nothing to do with the ball. Two D'ing him is dangerous. I guess punch him, because why not? It's a 2D with a roller, or it's a GFI. With him. I mean, this one first. It's got the reroll for it. Un ballon par terre est un ballon dangereux. Hey. He's not going to stop whining, is he? Il a le ballon en ligne de mire, mais va-t-il pouvoir le ramasser? C'est le moment de vérité. Juggernaut is only on blitz, yeah. No need to be quite so harsh, due to old Varnus. Fucking hell. That's fucking brutal. Hello, Jelly Deals. Howdy. I won't forget the title shot, don't worry, Al. We've got Wednesday WemDorp / World Class tonight, so things will happen. Right, so one a foul next turn with a roller if possible. Well, it's unlikely to be possible. But if it is possible. How'd you enjoy your fucking vanity pass, dickhead? Right. I'd like the trolls let us score.
Really. Get off my fucking pitch, prick.
Don't know how I can stop. Can't really stop him getting hit. I can't stop the runner getting hit either. I've got to foul him. I've actually got to foul him, actually. This is alright. Nice. Suffira-t-il à prendre le dessus ? I could stand there, so he's got a 4 plus dodge at least. I don't want to go for the handoff against the Troll Slayer and then fail it. Oh, fuck it, I will do. Oh, but then he can just blitz him with him. Yes. Alright, no roller foul. Tragic. But no roller foul. Boo. Never lucky. Yeah, thanks, Dilio, I think. Yeah. I really did want to track the foul. I really did. But, you know, this would have just been a simple dodge. What, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, dodge GFI for 2D. So. To be fair, I didn't hit gun for the handoff so much there just because I couldn't really get the runner safe, could I? Like, if I could have got the runner safe, then maybe I would have gone for the runner pickup. But without being able to get the runner safe, I think it was worth going for the Slayer handoff. Obviously now as well, if he does power the Slayer, at least the runner's there to pick up and score as well. So I didn't really hate that at all, actually, that handoff. I don't think that was as stupid as some greed handoffs I've seen. All right, Tony, yeah. I'd like to. Ugh. Hey. Fail and die. No, I think it's a good foul. This is a good foul. Gets the KO. And the send off. He's got a punch. In case of that. Oh, he's disconnecting before I score. What an absolute wanker. Well, Andre, sort out your PI. First of all, you let cheats in, and now you're letting someone who does this. You have better team, better luck, better dices. And I should have written and better play, shouldn't I? Yeah, it is kind of redundant, yeah. I didn't see it till now. I didn't even look at it. I don't like even looking at what these idiots write, to be honest. You know, they're just fucking salty venting, aren't they? It's not. Like, okay, it might have wound him up more. But, which would be funny. Yeah, like, you know, this is annoying, isn't it? Oh, no, okay, no, he's not. All right, fair enough. Fair enough.
You know what'll make you feel better? Back. Money.
Oh, thanks. Well, I take it back. He's actually returned. Oh, but now I can't do anything. Oh, because it's okay. It's catching up. Okay. So 3, four, five. I can't get two more players in. I think I need the reroll in case I fail it, so I just got to do the blitz, haven't I? Yep, I apologise. My deepest apologies. I thought that was a concede, but in doing it the worst way as well. Because that's really scumbaggy. It's only because it would have been really scumbaggy to have disconnected. Like, if he just conceded before the touchdown, that's fair enough. But I thought making us wait 6 minutes was super scumbaggy. But, I mean, don't blame him being pissed off with the match, right? Like, it's a horrible matchup, obviously, being 500 TV down. He's had pretty good luck, actually. He's had no removals whatsoever. What did Skuro say? Oh dear. Yeah. Call for the BB bully. Oh dear, I could have just said chuckles, but fuck it, I don't get it. Tons of mighty blow hits against Almiraid. The only removal is because he fouled somebody. We just stayed out. Oh dear. Yeah, exactly, Jahanian, yeah. Yeah. Oh, that was bad timing. Everyone knows you're a polite player. Oh well. Indeed, Kiwi. I mean, to be fair, I didn't do a rando pass in the backfield when I was 500 TV down. I'd already used a reroll on a pickup. Only one of us did that. But I can confirm that it's a fucking horrific play. And he should not have done it. I know, it's funny, isn't it? But that's it, man. I'm toxic, aren't I? Everyone knows I'm toxic, so... So there you go. Yeah, the dice could rob us. I shouldn't have been so dickish, because the dice could still rob us. I didn't want to be a cunt, but he made me. Maybe that's it. Maybe he's just trying to get the super look by, you know, being a twat. I just pushing a guy away. Blitz. 3D. Dudley Death Drop. Oh no, it's not. He's strength 4. What a fucking toolbag I am. Fucking player of the year there. Oh dear me. Bolt bitch can go for the ball. Doesn't matter. You didn't say the same when on the last season I destroy your chaos team. Not was, nor was too much funny. Not was too much funny, right? Oh, dear. Gloves off. Bit of M. Bison. Bit of M. Bison for him. This in tabletop, do you? Way too much funny. Oh dear. Oh no, Girdly. Oh no. Oh dear. It's definitely not Malmere or Orielensis. It's definitely not Malmere. Oh dear me. Oh dear, what's going on? I just don't even care now. He wants to blitz him with Mighty Blow, doesn't he? Oh, but then I can put the guard in. This guard can go into 2D him. Who do I get to Mighty Blow? I want to Mighty Blow somebody. He could go there at 2D. Then he blitzes him. Yeah, okay.
À quand un peu d'action? Si ça continue comme ça, je retourne regarder un épisode de Game of Gnome.
Hi, I'm Jimmy M. Bison. When I'm not burning down your villages and pillaging the countryside, I like to relax by dicing the shit out of salty coaches in Blood Bowl. Follow me on Twitch to watch me politely converse with my opponents.
Oh dear, thank you very much. Oh man, this is going pretty badly now. As is pretty much standard in these kind of games, isn't it? It all goes tits up once you get a bit fucking cocky.
Oh, hey, Wanger.
Right, let's get a pal. Oh dear me. Oh, I thought I was going to free up my slayer. Oh god, I'm an idiot. Oh god, I'm an idiot. Right. Don't want to reroll this already? I guess I do. Don't even need to, mate. Yeah, I've got to concentrate now. This is going real bad now. I mean, okay, I'm getting some good dice now. I've got to concentrate. I don't want to follow into Mighty Blow, so I'm just not going to punch there. Right, no, it's going bad in terms of how I'm thinking. I need to calm down and think and play properly.
Et puis paf!
Focus, you motherfucker, focus.
Thank you, Mr. Pounds TV. Fuckers.
Ce colosse va-t-il réussir à étendre un adversaire de moitié sa force? L'important n'est pas la taille, Bob.
Bien sûr que si.
Ça me rappelle la célèbre histoire Nurgling et Grand Immonde. Mais sans miracle ce coup-ci.
I like how the one motherfucker without guard is what gives Grashnak three dice. Oh, he's got two actually, because the bulk bitch doesn't have it. he just did the ha 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 ha. Hey, at least he's speaking English. They go ya normally, don't they? The Spaniards when they do the ha 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 thing. Right. He wants to punch him.
Ce joueur va se prendre un coup dessus et en dessous de la ceinture. Ce joueur préfère se battre entouré.
So we could put a guard in there to 2D him. Or a guard down here to blitz him. Could blitz him. I could just stand there and could block him. I think him blitzing him is the best. Letting Grashnak in behind us doesn't seem good. So actually,
du corps à corps, sans que ça va me plaire.
L'union fait la force. Il s'est fait poutrer. C'est bien comme ça que disent les jeunes de nos jours, non?
L'attaquant bénéficie de soutien. Très beau blocage, il s'est révélé payant. Sacré défait.
God, this is... Can't remove anyone! Oh, okay, somebody's gone apparently. 3, 6, 9... Yeah, he's still got 10. Oh dear, that was a laugh, that wasn't it? Holy shit, that was a laugh. Just rolled an Iliad and he scummed a wizard. Dirty Dino. It's not casual racism, it's how they spell ha ha ha, isn't it? The Spanish people spell ha 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 with J, don't they? And I know that, because I've always fucking understood, I've always, you know, been playing online games. I'm like, what the fuck does that mean? But then I realised it was like, because they don't pronounce it the same as us, do they? So they write ha 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 with J's normally. I wasn't being anything bad. I didn't say that, Elb. You said that. Oh, fuck.
I
knew I shouldn't have followed. I can't apple. Down to 10 aside. I'm gonna fucking draw this game. Oh, no. Oh, no. Jesus. Oh, yeah, I guess I just shouldn't have followed. But I didn't want it. I didn't want the warrior to run around and do something. That's actually pretty great, freeing up a player. Freeing up a cheeky guarder. Very nice of him. Before the 1-9? No. In fact, I could serve the warrior, couldn't I? I could 1D him, and then I could 1D him, and then I could serve. With the runner. Would be funny. Gymshard. Yeah, I just fork and like dodge through somehow. You could try and punch him. He's like, what the fuck does he need? He needs a 5+. He needs a 5+ to hit him. And then push him into there, doesn't even achieve anything. 1D gives us a 1D there. Could dodge him. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I don't know. Because if I don't hit, he can hit him, and he can hit him, and he can get a 3, 1, or 2+. I don't really want him to get through on the 3+. But I also don't want to base the ball with Grashnak, so I have to go even further back. That was a 4+. Oh well. Never lucky. Oh yeah, he's only strength 6. What a pussy. What a fucking pussy. Yeah, this guy hasn't. It was failed 2-2+ dauntlesses. Yeah, I just can't fucking do anything. Hey! Fail your loner, you motherfucker. You prick. He's been pretty fucking lucky this game, hasn't he? Imagine making that without standing up any of these guys or anything. Two stuns for Grashnak that turn. Not bad if you can get it. Yeah, do you hear me? Now this is looking real bad, isn't it? Now you can get some real pressure going. Maybe I should have moved up and not been so scared of the wrestle hit. Stop fucking crying now, hasn't he? Amazingly enough. Now that he can understand that he's getting really good dance.
If you want to be part of Team Positive, then you've got to fucking suck it up. Stop bitching like a little baby and try and fucking play better, eh? Mm-hmm.
It's a real fucking rough, really rough half this has been. He could blitz and assist and block, but he can still get us. He could block. He could blitz, assist, block, pass. That failed. We needed a pal there. We needed a 1D pal. Maybe I should have rerolled that uphill last turn. Yeah, one of them got fucking KO'd and the other one's been sent off. I had quite a few Mighty Blow, actually. This is the only player then now, isn't it? Like it or not, this is the only player. Go on the side where I've got the least players. Yeah, that's the only removal has been a KO. Oh, of course, the instant fucking one. Jesus. Really want the GFI because it would have made it a little bit harder for him. Good. That would have been real nice, wouldn't it? If that had been a 1D pal. That would have been the play. They would have been a great play if that had been a 1D pal. And obviously I had to be lucky. But a 1D pal could have then 2D'd him, pushed him to there, well, powered him again, wouldn't need a pal, run to there, surf him with the what's it called?
Glorious. Dude.
Then no, he would have been there, and the ball, you know, ball carried have been here and passed it to him, and then it would have been screened and everything.
I will defend.
Come on, double skull.
4, 5 beaver pregnancies for China, for China, for China.
Thank you very much, twice hopped. Glorious. It is 4.5 beaver pregnancies for China. Thank you very, very much. Absolutely glorious. Oh, this is a hard game. Really need Stand Firm to like not get knocked over. Not that Stand Firm would have mattered, really. No, he gets knocked over. I guess it's not a loss, right? It's not a loss, whatever happens. No, it's all right, Twitop. Thank you very much for staying fantastic. Yeah, I have KLZ, yeah. I mean, he was dicing his first half, really. He was taking zero damage from, like, 3 or 4 Mighty Blow hits every single turn. He was taking zero damage. And, yeah, now that it's... Now he's stuck. That's true, Bessel, yeah. That's true. Only push the Stand Firm guy. Bleh. Only 1D though, isn't it? There's no way to get the 2D. If only he got being pushed, then he's up there, and then he could have gone 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, GFI made it 2D. Oh god, if he makes this. That's still a 1D, doesn't even matter, does it? Oh, he's watching the stream, isn't he? No, that's good, because that idiotically makes it easier for us. Failing it is pretty terrible. Yeah, it was a horrible idea. An absolute justice. Right. Stand firm on him is good, isn't it? So go for this, then do the dodge 2D. Do I even want the scatter, the crowd scatter? I should have gone there and then I could have hit him that up. Oh, fuck. Oh, I could go this way. No.
Ils mettent la pression sur le porteur. Ça se tient.
Bon blocage défensif. Ball goes here, I'm fucked. Alright, good. Look a dog. Does he uphill him? Or dodge? Boo. Yeah, I guess I should have gone there. But I wanted to be behind him, you know, like if it did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I guess he just goes for the score, so I guess I should have been one higher up. I don't know. I just wanted to be nearer the end zone. Because, like, dwarves are slow, aren't they? I wanted to be nearer the end zone with the blitzer, but I guess I should have gone one up and then I could have gone and hit him up. Which would have been better than near the sideline. Because if this is a horrific throw-in, isn't it? This would have been all right. This would have been dangerous. But not terrible, because he could have only got this far forward. Instant. Whereas this would mean terror because he just picks it up with a warrior or the beastman and he fucks off and he's done. So I guess it was a 1 in 8 terror scatter, so it wasn't that bad odds. Yeah, Shag for God's quite the player's name, isn't it? Yeah, no, he's not terrible, is he? He's just a fucking whiny bastard. He's just a fucking whiny bastard. No re-roll now. Where does he go?
c'est tout sauf une bonne idée de finir sa course si près de la ligne de douche. C'est un coup à se faire pousser dans la foule. La dernière fois que c'est arrivé, il a fallu 3 jours pour reconstituer le...
That's where he goes, isn't it?
Fuck. Funny that 4+ had worked. I don't even know what the best player here is. 1D looks a bit more tempting now that there's a, you know, players.
Il s'acharne sur ce pauvre joueur comme des halflings autour d'un sandwich. L'attaquant bénéficie de soutien.
Herp derp.
Because I feel the dodge here, at least he's got stand firm and he's back there. Whereas if I fail this dodge, then there's nothing. But I guess he could just scores anyway, right? Doesn't really matter if this guy's here or not. I guess just have to push him back on this turn. He's whining. His constant string of good dice is not held up for the entirety of the match, so he must complain. And there's a one. Bolt, bitch. Nah, it doesn't matter. I'm 1-0 up. I've just got to... That's why it's a Canoring threat, Duod Varnis. That's exactly why it's a Canoring threat. Because only a push is... Like, you know, I'm winning 1-0. A Canoring threat takes a player out of the game. He could have ran up and gone there and done nothing. Whereas now, if he had made this, it makes his score harder and hence the win more likely. So that is exactly why it's a Canoring threat. Because it's, it's lowering your odds of winning the game. Or drawing. I mean, normally it'd be in a 0-0, you know, it would be optimistic. But it's kind of crazy in a 1-0. Valve doesn't know how to do that. Yeah, the push was fine for that turn, wasn't it? Get the push, then he runs back and he 2Ds him, and then, you know, reassess next turn. He still gets 2D on the ball and a pickup, doesn't he? And 2D on the ball, 2D on my guy. Oh, he doesn't because of the guard. He gets 1D on him and then picks up and runs somewhere. Yeah, but after the rest of the half, KLZD, you've taken zero damage. This was a rock. You've taken zero damage, 500 TV down against, like, a brutally scary team. So, in the context of the game, it was a pretty bullshit 1D. Of course it was. Dodging a 1D, getting the power is always nice, isn't it? But, given the context of the game, is triple skull before he stood anybody up. was unlucky, but again, he didn't stand anybody up first. I'm not going to pull off a calcium. I don't know what a calcium is, but it's all right, isn't it? This is tricky for him now. Very tricky for him now. I think we've done just about enough to get the win now. Hey. Woo! Meru.
What can this guy do? This guy can go in here to make this a 2D to get another player into the ball.
Glorious. No, I won't give in. Until I'm victorious. And I will defend. I will defend.
Cheers, Jim.
Ah. Sorry, I'll thank you later. Thank you very much. Nice. Knocking down everybody here. Neither knockdown here, or just screen him heavily. Get the knockdown. He's got no one in range.
Wonderful. He will surf him just out of spite, I'm sure, and he will hit him out of spite as well if he can. He should run away. I could foul him, actually. I could just foul somebody, couldn't I?
Yeah, I don't hate going for the vanity pass. I could do it on him, so if he gets an MVP, he levels, doesn't he? There's absolutely no way he can score. 1, 2, 3, GFI, GFI. Do the 1D first, that's the most important.
Yeah, exactly, Bezel. He's in the stream, I'm pretty sure, so. He's already been reminded of that. Blah.
I hope we can play another time when the TV are the same. I don't know, I think you'll wind that game too. GG. That's DG. Oh god, not myself. Not myself. Oh. It is more like that, Jimmy, yeah, but still, it was still fun, wasn't it? Some might say that, Jimmy, but I enjoyed this. So that was alright, wasn't it? I enjoyed it. I really thought he was being a dick when he did the concede thing, like, you know, when he disconnected, but he really wasn't, so fair enough. Fair play to him, he wasn't that bad. But it's just annoying sometimes, isn't it, when people whine the whole game. 81 blocks. 0 cards. 2 KOs. On a mostly defenseless, mostly armor 8 team against 4 mighty blows. But you know, he was super unlucky. 86% armor. Oh dear. 5 out of 6 dodges, 4 out of 4 GFIs. 42
42, 27. Okay, his block dice were horrendous. Can't argue with that. 49, 46, 60. So pretty great block dice. I had GFIs. 46 dodges were incredible. Catches, but they were scatters, I think. Dauntless, the two ones were bad, but overall, it doesn't really matter. Mostly weren't relying on Dauntless, mostly. And then there was a double one pickup, but it didn't matter, did it? So there you go, it was probably about even. I mean, well, not really about even. I did have much better block dice. But the second, like, it was kind of made closer by the fact that it just didn't remove anybody with the 81 blocks. That's the thing, isn't it? The only removal was... There were two removals. He fouled somebody and the rock KO'd somebody. Oh, dear. Right. Literally inflicted nothing. 81 in a 16-turn game is a lot. You do get more with Frenzy, so it's a bit misleading. But anyway, I don't know. Hopefully you'll see that he was a bit of a whiny cunt and won't complain about it. Right. Because obviously it was a bit of banter, but, you know. And there's just no need to whine at your opponent, is there ever? And so I prefer to give them a bit of needle back rather than just say nothing. I mean, saying nothing's fair enough, isn't it? So maybe I should have said nothing, but it was fun. And what you're here to do if not to have fun? So there you go. Right, thanks for watching. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. And stay fantastic.